Well, the Drexel Dragons, champs of the CAA, defeated Elon, James Madison, and the top seed Delaware to win the championship. They have a dynamic duo, Washington and Nihil. Two players to watch this afternoon.
Yeah, this is a team where their offense really runs through these two players. It's a screen, very screen-heavy type of offense, but these two you're going to see are going to take the most shot attempts. You got to know Georgia has their eyes locked on these two ladies.
Underway in San Antonio, day two of the first round. The opening tap controlled by the Georgia Lady Bulldogs, dressed in the white uniforms. Inside and off the mark was Kayla Coombs, who got the start, and a foul inside. To take a look at today's Capital One starting lineups, we mentioned for the Bulldogs, those changes, no Gabby Connolly and no Jenna Stady. Maya Caldwell, Jordan Isaacs, Mallory Bates making her first career start, and in fact is at the free throw line as we speak.
So many players to keep your eye on in this game for Georgia, but one of the players who stood out to me is Q Morrison, number 23. She's a player who's dealt with injuries throughout her entire career. Now she's back to a place of being healthy, and the way that she plays, she ignites the team with her energy. And often, she'll be the one literally getting into the faces of her players saying, guys, let's go. She's a fun, energetic player. You want to keep your eyes on her.
Take a look at today's Capital One starting lineups for the Dragons. Mariah Leonard just picked up her first foul. And Shatman making her fifth consecutive start. Just a sophomore out of Pennsylvania. Drexel's off the mark. Here come the Lady Bulldogs once again. And off the steal, Nihil transition.
Well, Drexel, knowing they're outsized, decide to triple team down low, and they end up with a turnover. They're going to have to be active on the glass. You know, Nihil is a player, and then the turnover there travel for Morrison. Nihil is a player who is so active and will shoot quickly. She's not afraid, Roy, to take 15, 20, 25 shots. She'll take the bulk of the scoring load, and for Drexel, it's second chance opportunities. It's points off turnovers. Can they get those types of scoring?
Washington lost the handle. It'll stay on this end. First basket for the Dragons. Mariah Leonard went off glass to tie us up at two. Just a minute in. A little surprised we didn't see upsets yesterday, Brooke, but as we mentioned right out of the gate, that usually translates into insanity on day two. So we'll see if perhaps that starts in this matchup.
Yeah, I mean, I'm ready for a little craziness. We saw Stephen F. Austin almost provide an upset yesterday. A nail biter down to the end. Probably the closest we came, though.
SEC Coach of the Year, Joni Taylor. First time in 11 years that the better seeded teams went undefeated any single day in the dance.
Yeah. Well, for a year that was so uncertain and unpredictable, it's weird to have that much predictability on day one. Like, we can't have that.
Yeah, great call by you suggesting we'd see upsets galore yesterday. Shot is short by Leonard.
Hey, look at my men's bracket. It's been on fire since day one, so I'm not saying take my advice in either.
Morrison tosses up an air ball back to the Dragons. So I think the theory applies here, a 14 seed versus a 3. Imperative that Drexel gets off to a good start as the hang-around team to have a chance to pull off the upset.
Yeah, you have to show confidence early and success in scoring early. You know, Joni Taylor talked about how this team runs oftentimes a five out. There's a lot of heavy screens, so you got to be ready to move without, you know, the player who's got the ball, which means great help side, shielding the back door. This is good defense so far by Georgia. Look at how high and far they're coming up to guard off the screen.
Nihil throws one up there quickly, and Drexel has its first lead.
Nihil plays with no fear. Such a fun player to watch.
First team all conference. Super quick with the ball or without.
Yeah.
Defensive player of the year in the CAA was Hannah Nihil. Younger sister Sydney is in attendance. Here in San
Antonio.
Are you
talking about Sid the Kid now, right? Sid the Kid.
Sid the Kid, that's right.
Yeah. Sid the Kid's a celebrity.
Washington in transition. Zappin is short. And a sloppy start in this one. And players all over the place.
Yeah. you know, teams, again, trying to find their rhythm. And you're not surprised because this is the first time all season Georgia has not started in this lineup. Right, so to get into their flow is a much different situation than it has been for 26 games.
Right, and I think that's kind of the key note there. Three-pointer is short. It'll stay the Lady Bulldogs.
Hannah Nyhill, part of the dynamic duo. Nice one or two dribble pull-up. She's left-handed, so if you're guarding her, naturally you're going to think about forcing a player left, but that's her strong side. You're going to be backwards in your thinking. But you're right, she's got so many different types of shots in her arsenal, and she's quick about every one.
Well, Georgia clearly out of sync, and we mentioned without two key starters to begin this one, and that's a little different for this team compared to others because Georgia had the same starting five the entire season. They started all 26 games in the COVID era, playing in a pandemic. That literally is incredible. We talked with Joni Taylor about that. And you see they actually lead the country in terms that same starting five for the most games this year at 26. That's every regular season and SEC tournament contest.
Well, I think it speaks to everything about the Georgia program and what Joni Taylor does, right? So you've got everybody that's stayed in that freshman class now for 4 years. Nobody has transferred. And I loved the note in their game notes about the top four scorers. They're seniors, they're graduates, and they're graduate students. So she has built a culture in this program of trust, of accountability, of the senior class taking on, setting up that environment so that everybody does their part and follows the rules and sacrifices. And I mean, you look back to what Joni Taylor does. I mean, she gets up at 4 o'clock in the morning and runs 3 to 6 miles 6 days a week. So
Joni,
that just gives you
now
an idea. She does.
That's early.
So it's incredible. So, she sets the example.
Mariah Leonard just picked up her second personal. She has half of Drexel's 4 points, really halfway through our first quarter. And another turnover. Dogs still looking for their first field goal.
Right, and we heard Jenna Stady to play limited minutes. And the reasoning we got for that was an undisclosed medical reason. She was late to make the trip here. So, you wonder what it is that's going on and how many minutes is she going to play and when's she going to come in the ball game. A start
Nyhill
for Drexel. Yeah, not a fast start for either team, but Nyhill taking charge.
Another turnover. Nyhill comes away with it. And on the backdoor cut, a foul called as Nyhill tried to get close to the rim. It'll go against the Lady Bulldogs. So Coombs picks up her first. Drexel leading 6-2. Winner of this game will match up with the winner of Oregon and South Dakota later tonight. Amy Mallon in her first season. Great job she's done. Anytime you can get a team to the tournament for the first time in 12 years and you do it during a pandemic, pretty incredible.
Oh, I give these coaches and programs so much credit. Everybody that was able to find a way to keep their teams positive, motivated, ready to play. I mean, it wasn't just the physical battles of staying healthy. There's so many mental health stories and tragedies that we've heard throughout this season that you can just only imagine how hard that would be for these players and coaches to be a part of. So to be in this tournament now, man, it is extra rewarding this year.
Nyhill nearly turns it over. Georgia still has yet to make a field goal.
All right. Little Harlem Globetrotters out there.
Nyhill the step back triple. That may have been partially deflected out of bounds.
Hannah Nyhill has 4 of the team's 8 points. Some of the things she's really good at is just being quick, catching you off guard. Here she is with a pull-up jump shot. And again, can't get enough looks of that.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Always a great feeling on Selection Monday, especially when you understand it's just your second ever trip to the big dance. And the Georgia Lady Bulldogs set to welcome Jenna Stady on the floor for the first time. Did not make the start for the first time this season. She's traveling late to San Antonio for an undisclosed medical reason. Did not start today. She is on the floor. Georgia looking for its first made field goal of this game, Brooke.
Man, Stady makes such a difference when she's in the game. She's 6'4", an incredible target with as long as her arms are. She's got great positioning and footwork. So not only that, she can stretch the defense and step out. So I think you're going to see a much different look for Georgia now that she's in the game.
Second team All-SEC, 50-plus percent from the floor. Off the Georgia turnover, Drexel back to work. And a steal. Kayla Coombs coast to coast, and there it is, 8-4.
Doesn't surprise me that number four, Michaela Coombs, is guarding Hannah Nyhill. Coombs loves football, and she loves to translate that role on the basketball court as being a defensive back. And there's another steal. She's got two in a row.
Morrison comes away with it. Georgia off the turnover, a chance to make it a one-possession game.
Not a lot of movement, though. Look at everybody standing still for Georgia.
Morrison directing traffic. Shot clock under 10. Caldwell rejected. Satman got in there.
Tell you what, the team defense for Drexel here in this first quarter has been phenomenal. I'm seeing triple teaming of the post, active hands, some block shots, clogging up the lane when Georgia wants to try and drive. They've been very fundamental in their approach, and it's been effective.
Nyhill lost the handle. Five to shoot for Washington. No. Tracked down by Satman. And a fresh 20. Rhythm three. Count it, 11-4, Drexel, Washington's first points.
That was a hustle possession by Drexel. They got a good shot. They hustled to get an offensive rebound. Then you end the play with an assist of your dynamic duo. And Stady's frustrated. And she wanted a foul on that play. She's saying, listen, she's holding me right here. You're looking right at it. And that's the active hands for Drexel. You're a post player, and we will feed on that all day long. You bring that ball down below your shoulders, it's game on. Otherwise, really, we can't touch it.
Yeah, first touch for Stady did not go well. Drexel with possession, leading by 7, under 2 to go in the first. Washington scored 30-plus in her last two games of the CAA tournament. First time in Drexel history that happened. How about the dish and Satman inside connects?
That was part of the game plan. Drexel wanted to pull Jenna Stady away from the post. When you do that, you make her susceptible to backdoor cuts like this. Remember, she's just getting into this game, so her legs aren't exactly there yet. She goes high on the ball screen, and a great read by Hedda Satman. Cuts back door, and there's another assist.
A foul called against Bacon. Kayla Bacon picks up her first. Amy Mallon, Shauna Washington talking things over on the sideline. Perfect start for the Dragons, seeking that upset. Couple of free throws by Coombs.
Drexel with 4 assists already on 6 field goals. Georgia just with 1 field goal in this game, so they have yet to get on the assist board, but they got to get on the scoreboard. And now we see really what kind of effect the change in the starting lineup, right? It's making an effect for sure. Georgia has not been in their flow in this game, and credit Drexel's defense for sure. But Georgia just does not look like themselves right now.
Chapman gets the bounce.
Chloe Chapman, dual sport athlete at the University of Georgia, on the soccer team as well. Great acceleration and confidence to hit the pull-up jumper.
Isn't that amazing to play soccer and basketball at an SEC school?
Are you kidding me? That is incredible. And you know, as a soccer player, like, she doesn't have the ability to get tired. It just doesn't happen.
Right. Washington again in rhythm, again knocks it down.
Dynamic duo did not come to play today. They came to win. Keep Washington.
15-8.
Yeah, the sixth player of the year in the CAA. And I have a feeling that wasn't quite good enough for her. I know she's done that and on the third team this year, and I feel like she might be trying to prove a few people wrong in the conference to say, y'all should have voted me higher.
Well, she did that in the CAA tournament. I mentioned those last two games, 30-plus in both.
Yep.
We asked her about it, and she said, yeah, I knew I was in the zone early. My teammates kept getting me the basketball. Amy Mallon said that was really our strategy once we realized what was happening.
And how about the defense inside? Again, Drexel's bigs are stepping up as Georgia finally gets a bucket, another one. Well, they needed that. The defense of Drexel's been tough. Hannah Nyhill, Key Washington, the dynamic duo.
Hannah Nyhill's story has been incredible on the court for Drexel, but her greatest assist may come away from the game. Her story and how she saved her little sister's life is coming up next. Well, it's hard to believe it's been almost 6 years when Hannah Nyhill's little sister, Sydney, was diagnosed with leukemia. After several months of treatment, it was determined she needed a bone marrow transplant. And as it turned out, the only match in her family was her big sister, Hannah. These sisters have shared so much in life, and their connection runs much deeper than most realize.
My whole life is basketball, obviously, because of Hannah. So ever since I was little, I would just love going to her games, and I would just love watching her play, and I would just, like, I look up to her, not only basketball, but in life too. But it was just so cool how she's the smallest one on the court, but in my eyes, she was the best one on the court because she's my sister. Now that I found out that she was going to be my bone marrow, I was like, oh my gosh, like, this just brought us even closer because I literally have her in me. So, I mean, I think it was just, I don't know. I was so happy that it was her too, because also hoping for some basketball skills, but that didn't happen. But yeah, she's my best friend. So, I mean, I couldn't ask for a better donor than her.
That, y'all, is Sid the Kid. What an amazing young woman she is. And you just light up hearing about the love that she has and the pride that she has for her big sister, Hannah. And I love the story that she told us about after the procedure. She was in the hospital bed. Hannah was in a different room and was not doing well. So Hannah was brought into her room. And they both looked at each other as Hannah was lying down on the couch and Sydney was also lying down in her bed. And they kind of fell asleep looking at each other, smiling. And she said when she woke up, you know, everything was much better. And so just you love that sense of connection that they have. And I mean, she's a stand-up comedian. I wish I also got some of her basketball skills, but unfortunately I didn't. I mean, that's hilarious. She's just got such a great sense of humor and personality. And you feel the connection between these two. And I mean, who wouldn't be a fan of Hannah watching her play today?
Great to see Sid the Kid in attendance, checking on her big sister. And she's off to a great start. Her team is off to a fast start. We're looking for the first upset of the dance. We may be well on our way this afternoon.
Georgia's got to find a way to score. I mean, look at the triple team defense that Drexel's bringing inside. Then when you've got the drivers, ooh, Hugh Morrison. This is where the intensity of Q Morrison is going to open up. Watch this play here. Takes it to the basket. Defense is there. Jumps out of the way. That's a tough shot to make. After she makes it, you see how the way she pumps her fist? She is the energy giver to this team. She plays with so much passion.
Jumper by Morrison at the end of the first quarter, and then another to start our second. And she has single-handedly put Georgia within two.
That's right. Gratchy hit that shot at the end of the first.
Gabby Connolly also on the floor for the first time now for the Lady Bulldogs. Here's a steal. Kayla Coombs tried the Euro.
And Nyhill just got bumped hard in the lane. That's going to be a foul, number 22, Mallory Bates. McCombs trying to do that Euro step. And I think Nihil might have gotten a piece of that ball on the way over. Let's take a look at this shot. Well, that is a welcome to the SEC moment right there. Sid the kid, she's like, look, my sister can take a beating. She knows, she's tough. Get right back up.
I don't know
up.
How many more she can take like that.
Check a rib at halftime. Check
That's
all
right.
good.
Nihil, quick trigger. Dogs a chance now to tie it. Connolly first touch, turns it over.
Ten
and
turnovers.
The outlet goes
so far.
Out of bounds.
For Georgia, 10 turnovers here in this game. Drexel's defense is doing an excellent job of making it difficult, you know, for entry passes, for skip passes, everything.
Only lead for Georgia in this game. It was 2-0. Since then, Drexel been outstanding defensively. Lady Bulldogs out of sync on offense, missing two starters majority of that first quarter. Open look for Caldwell. And it'll stay on this end. Shot clock at 4. Coombs. And tapped out. It'll go back to Drexel. 7 to go in our first half. The tournament that's seeking its first upset.
Well, neither team shooting well from behind the three-point line. You know, a lot has been earned either in the paint or some pull-up jumpers. But the footwork of Nihil has been really impressive to me. You see that quick crossover led to a shot, but no going for Drexel. Not shooting too well as a team. 33%, but Georgia not doing well either. They're 25.
Yeah, I think if you would have told Amy Mallon, the head coach of the Drexel Dragons pregame, you're going to make 7 of your first 21 shots. You'll be 1 of 8 from 3, and yet you're going to have a lead in the second quarter.
Sure.
I don't think she would have believed you.
Sure.
Ball movement crisp this time, and the offense is there. The basket by Caldwell.
Maya Caldwell's played really well. Last 4 games coming into this one, averaging 18 points. And one of the many seniors that has been just such a big contributor to this team, making it to the SEC All-Tournament team.
As she started her last 57 games in a row. Senior from Charlotte, number 11 in white.
In graduate school to get her master's in nonprofit management and leadership. And we mentioned it earlier that there's 4 seniors who have graduated and are in graduate school. That is incredible to me.
Bacon baseline rejected. Sneaking in was Bates. Drexel gets it back in the bucket by Borky.
Good second chance effort. That's now the 5th offensive rebound of the game for Drexel. It's been one of the things giving them this narrow lead.
Aiken with the board. Nihil making things happen as she's done most of this game thus far.
Good with either hand, too. She can dribble hard left, she can dribble hard right.
I was going to say, she's also fun to watch even when she doesn't have possession, because she's just bouncing around all over the place.
I mean, you better bring your stamina if you're trying to guard her. And you see Georgia has switched up now to Gabby Connolly guarding Nihil before you saw Michaela Coombs. So Joni Taylor wants to keep them guessing.
Coombs forced the 5-second call. Yeah, it was funny. We talked with Hannah about maybe who she tries to pattern her game after. She was growing up and even now, and she's like, you know, I'm not really a basketball junkie, believe it or not. I'm like, What are you talking about, Hannah? You're one of the best players in your league. It's a basketball family. Your little sister, Sid the Kid. She's like, yeah, I'm really not. I do a bunch of other things like watch Friends.
Yeah.
On television.
Yeah. No. I love her honesty. But it just goes to show she kind of developed her own style. So everything you're seeing is Nihil exclusive.
Hose is checked in. Number 10 in white for Georgia. Shot clock under 10, and she'll launch from downtown. And connect a big shot, and the Dogs have their lead the first time since it was 2-0.
And the first three of the game to fall for Georgia. That was a big one. Now you can feel, you know, 5 minutes left here in the second quarter. Georgia has to feel a lot more confident now that they've established the lead. Now to them, it's like, hey, can we build on this? We got a new lineup, yes, but let's start getting in our groove and just playing Georgia basketball. Aggressive defense, smart shots on offense.
Borky inside, that's going to be an offensive foul. Lady Bulldogs with the advantage as we step aside in San Antonio.
The NCAA Women's Championship, presented by Capital One, is brought to you by Can-Am.
Riggs, Drea Carter, Monica McNutt with the studio update, and over on ESPN, Bama up over North Carolina. Drea, how about Jordan Lewis?
I love that she is being aggressive. She needs to look to score early and often. The Tide's getting it done.
I wish folks could see me watching BYU Rutgers. I got popcorn. This has just been a great basketball game so far.
2-point game right now and a close one for you guys, Roy and Brooke.
Kelsey, thank you so much. When Monica's got the popcorn ready, I've got mine watching hers, because I tell you what, she's been all over the place. I see her on these Around the Horn shows, and she's been just dominating social media. Monica McNutt getting it done. Always great to see her in for halftime support.
Oh, yeah. Love to see that. Love to see Drea Carter in the studio. Kelsey, you holding it down. And love to see Maria and Coach Landers in there as well. We got a nice team of coverage, don't we, throughout this tournament?
Yes, we do.
Whatever you need. At every she's game, Brooke. Every angle.
I'm Roy. Every angle, every game, like she said. And we're trying to break it down as best as we can in these pandemic conditions. Drexel right now breaking it down off the bounce. Nihil on cue. Drexel back in front. Sid the Kid feeling it.
Nihil's got that quick crossover to jump shot move. Got to stay close to her. She's probably not going to go all the way into the bucket. You know, she's undersized. So she's going to use all 5'3 of what she has and get that pull-up jump shot.
Hose, second shot off the bench from bonus land, and that's another big one.
Finally for Georgia, their three starting to come around. Hose is 2-for-2 from the three, and sometimes it's those unsung heroes that come up big in the tourney.
Yeah, she doesn't even average 2 points per game. She has 6 off the bench. Tracked down by Hannah Nihil. Offensive rebound, Kayla Bacon, and we're tied.
Well, Drexel's been able to get after the boards and get those second chance points. They're now 9 in this game off of 7 offensive rebounds. So they've converted on quite a few of those. And for Georgia, so many scores. Hose coming into the game, knocking down some threes. Coach Taylor able to play 10 or 11 players at times. So there's a lot of different rotations and looks that you got to prepare for defensively. But Georgia is turning the ball over too much.
Well, all 4 NIT quarterfinals come to ESPN Networks Thursday, beginning with Mississippi State and Richmond, 6 Eastern, on ESPN2, also the ESPN app, and visit NCAA.com. The home for all 90 NCAA championships. Brooke, are you surprised by what we've seen here so far?
Well, I'm surprised that we had a different Georgia lineup. I think that was the biggest surprise of them all. But after you saw that, it didn't surprise me that it's taken them some time to get into the flow of their offense. Drexel's just playing lights out. I mean, they're playing with nothing to lose. They're the 14 seed. So they're showing up and doing everything that they're supposed to do.
Say hello to Tori Hajduk, who just connected on the triple. Drexel back in front. Good feed inside, and the bucket, Javon Nicholson, her first points.
Great move by Javon Nicholson, who was double-teamed right away. able to get some spacing and get a clean look at the bucket. That's one of the few times that Georgia's been able to get the entry pass into the post. They make a move and finish the shot.
Seconds to go in our first half. Iduke lost the handle for a minute. 9 seconds to shoot for Drexel. Savin kept it alive. And the skip pass sails out of bounds. Well, coming up at the AT&T 5G Halftime Report, Kelsey, Monica, Drea will be in the studio covering all the games currently underway. Carolina, Bama over on ESPN, BYU and Rutgers. How about the Texas A&M Aggies? Brooke, are they getting enough credit?
According to me, they are. They are in my Final Four. The Aggies are rolling. They've got a good balanced team. You know, there's not one superstar averaging 20 points a game. You know, they've got the ability to be balanced, just like Georgia does. You know, in a conference, the SEC was so tough this year.
Aggies beating South Carolina, final day of the regular season to claim the regular season crown. Nyhill throws it up, gets the bounce. She's got eight.
It's a big possession for Drexel. Just from being strong, being competitive standpoint, I think they want to prove to themselves that they can hold this lead here going into halftime. You see Nyhill just turn around, little clap to her teammates.
I was waiting for her to slap the floor and get down in the defensive stance.
Like little Wojo?
That's right. Shot clock at 5. Lady Bulldogs have to hurry here. Morrison, deep triple. And Morrison working hard. She's been so good at the end and start of these quarters off the steal. That could have been huge, and we end exactly where we started. We are tied at 25. Entertaining first two quarters in the books in San Antonio. We'll send you now to the studio, the Halftime Report. Women's Championship presented by Capital One. Back in San Antonio, Alamo Region, we are tied at 25, two quarters to go in an exciting first-round matchup between the number 3 seed Georgia Lady Bulldogs and the Drexel Dragons. And away we go for our second half. An interesting start in this one, Brooke. And Hannah Nyhill was one of the big stories with 8 first-half points for Drexel.
Yeah, she's been the hustle player and the one that set the tone for this team to start the game. And at 5'3", she's got to make the most out of her height. And she's just a brilliant player when it comes to creating separation for herself. This is against Michaela Combs. She is a terrific defender for Georgia. You see, they're about even right here. Now watch the right foot of Nyhill. Plants, create separation, the step back. That's a lot of room for a 5'3 player. Don't need much if you're Hannah Nyhill. You can just get the shot off. And then the hustle plays for Georgia have been big. Hugh Morrison is that player for them. To end the first quarter, she hits a shot. At the end of the second quarter, everybody else is looking. Hugh is hunting for the offensive rebound, able to put up this shot to get the second chance points and to tie up the ball game. So she had a big shot to end the first quarter and end the second.
In the first 20 minutes looked like this. Turnover is a big story. Lady Bulldogs with those 13 miscues. That's actually a turnover on 43% of their total possessions in our first half. And we really haven't seen a lot. Jenna Stady did not start, arrived to San Antonio late, and only played a couple of minutes. She will begin the second half on the bench as well for an undisclosed medical reason. Underway, Drexel with possession in a tournament seeking its first upset. The Dragons happy to partake if they can continue this current stretch. Good look from Washington. Leonard off the mark. And a wild shot by Connolly. It's off the mark too.
Yeah, I think Washington should have taken that shot, honestly. I know she passed it up for a better shot, but she's one of the players that you want to see get established in this game if you're Drexel. She's got to start getting more aggressive.
and had those two jumpers, one from downtown, the other foot on the line, 5 first-half points. She scored almost 70 in her last two games combined in the CAA tournament. Shot clock under 10. Nifty pass from Washington. Satman off the mark. The rebound. Fought for and controlled by Drexel somehow.
The 50-50 balls in this game have been big as well. And you know, that goes along with things like rebounding, offensive rebounds, giving yourself another life.
Spin by Washington. The stutter step. She
nice
stepped
move.
Out of bounds.
She stepped. Well, it looked good up until the turnover. That's where Key Washington really is so good. You know, off the drive she can create, but Coach Mallon feels like her best movement is her off-ball movement. So I'd like to see her maybe get off some screens, get some open looks, and get involved offensively in this game. She's got to show it that she wants to be here and not just rely on Nihil to shoot.
Dragons drop back in a zone. Morrison with 7 points in the first half. Booms off the mark. Drexel the rebound. That's Mariah Leonard. Winner of this game will get the winner, 6 seed Oregon and number 11 seed South Dakota. That game late tonight at 10 Eastern. Tapped out, it'll stay with Drexel. Nihil couldn't connect inside under duress.
We have yet to score here in the second half. A lot of energy being expelled, but no buckets, Sue. Count for it. You get
so
the sense both
you.
Teams. Sorry, Roy, just that they came out of the locker room and it was like, all right, we're going to give more defensive energy. We're going to hustle more. You're seeing that, and it's still canceling each other out. I'm trying to get a good look.
Washington left open. Morrison the rebound. I was going to ask you, Brooke, at what point does the pressure really start to ratchet up on the number 3 seed in a matchup like this?
You know, Georgia is a very veteran team. They're not going to get rattled. When you have a team of seniors the way they do and Coach Taylor, they are not going to get upset. But what you will see, though, you see the top of the key there, number 23, Q Morrison. I think you're going to see her intensity ratchet up even more. She's demands more out of her teammates, and they need that right now. They need somebody to get really excited and really angry to make sure they're giving everything they got.
Caldwell comes up with the steal, ahead to Coombs. Layup is good and a chance for three.
That's what you're looking for. That's what you're looking for right there. Michaela Coombs, so good here in the transition off the pass ahead from Caldwell, and has that athleticism to leap, wait for Hannah Nihil to go by her and then shoot. Some of us can only dream to be that gifted, right?
I'm with you on that one. Off the mark on the free throw. First points of the second half. Lady Bulldogs lead it by 2. Nihil wanted the foul, didn't get the whistle. Drexel so active defensively, bothering Georgia in every facet of the game thus far.
I would like to have seen Maya Caldwell take that shot. Georgia a little too unselfish on that possession, allowing Drexel to get back involved defensively. Nihil to get in there and start swatting at the ball.
Joni Taylor, SEC Coach of the Year, complimented her team on her toughness and relentlessness. Our conversations this week. You said our 4 seniors, the heart and soul of our program, they have a no-flinch mentality. That's going to be tested if this game continues to be close in the fourth quarter. Satman open, corner shot, no good, in and out, tapped out. It'll stay on this end of the floor.
Again, Washington giving up a shot for an assist there. Satman with the 3 didn't hit it. It almost went down, but again, that's another shot Key Washington's got to take.
A turnover on the inbounds. Gabby Connolly. Poked away by Morrison. Well, make sure you tune in Friday when the Men's Ice Hockey Championship gets underway in Bridgeport. It's at 1 Eastern on ESPN and also the ESPN app. Wisconsin in the regional semis. Make sure you visit NCAA.com, the home for all 90 NCAA championships. Nyhill.
She had to will that ball to get to the rim. It felt like it took a lot of strength the way she shot it. Well, I got a friendly bounce, and that's a heads-up play there by Q Morrison to bounce it off Nyhill, going out of bounds. Nyhill turned around just in time. Yep. Again, little stutter step. Great separation to get the shot.
Stady, her first points. Georgia back in front. I thought Nyhill's basket was a three.
It looked like it, but we'll have to go back and review. And again, one of the things I absolutely hate right now are the 2 3-point lines. Can we make just 1 3-point line? It's so confusing.
I think that is point that is well taken. Two-point contest. Another turnover for Drexel. Quickly ahead to Coombs. Georgia now leads it by 4. And a timeout going to be called.
Michaela Coombs has been a hero in this quarter. Athleticism getting to the rim and extending Georgia's lead. The Bulldogs on a run thanks to Michaela Coombs, who's done a fantastic job on the defensive end. And then finishing in transition. These are the easy buckets that help you win basketball games. And Coombs showing incredible athleticism in the open floor. Well, she wanted to be a defensive back. Loves football. And here she is, going to convert for the interception. And right on cue, Q Morrison stepping up with some defense of her own. So between these two, and really stepping up for the absence of the point production from Stady, have been the difference in this game.
3-seed Georgia now with its largest lead at just 4 points. We are halfway through the third quarter. Drexel's only scored 2 thus far in the second half. And a foul, what could have been a turnover, as Coombs came barreling through. Another timeout as we step aside in San Antonio. Coming up next over on ESPN, the NCAA Women's Championship first round continues with these matchups. Wright State, Arkansas, followed by Mount St. Mary's and Maryland, the 2-seed. Those are 2 and 4. Michigan State, Iowa State at 6. And Marist and Louisville at 8 o'clock tonight over on ESPN. Jeff Wall is trying to win a championship. And the winner of that game advancing on to the second round, as will the winner of this one. 4-point game in San Antonio. That shot off the mark by Borky.
I was going to say, a lot of good star power in that bracket right here, though. We've got some business to finish up. Georgia able to pull ahead by 4, but have not been on that killer run yet to kind of establish themselves as the dominant team in this game. Almost always, Roy, the more aggressive team will win the game. And I'd say that advantage, for the most part, to me, is slightly Drexel, I think, in this game. Georgia, they were out of their flow without the usual starting lineup, and they've been trying to find their way back ever since. Caleb Combs and Q Morrison have been a big reason for that.
Stady hit the deck. It's going to stay with the Lady Bulldogs. 4:12 remaining in the third quarter, and Stady only 2 points as a leading scorer and second-team All-SEC performer. Did not start. Arrived late to San Antonio, if you're just joining us, for an undisclosed medical condition. She has been on the floor often in the second half. And off the inbounds, Lady Bulldogs connect. The lead extends to 6. Stady now her second bucket.
Really nice execution out of bounds for Georgia. Quick shot for Stady. She's got that quick release, and you see the large wingspan. They're trying to bring her outside, though, outside of the post, so they can open up that lane.
You wonder if this is the run Georgia's been waiting on. Nyhill off the mark. Drexel still just 1 basket in this third quarter, and that's it.
Yeah, Drexel has not shot well. Georgia's defense has turned up, and the Bulldogs have not turned the ball over this quarter. They had 13. 15 of them in the first half.
Dragons needed that basket from Nyhill. She has 12, the lead trimmed to 4. Nearly had the steal.
Nyhill slow to get up, holding her face.
Stady now with 6. Check to see if Nyhill's okay, and that left side clearly in pain.
Yeah, looks like she took a shot. Let's see what happened here. Oh yeah, just ran right into Combs. Got hit on the right side of her face there. Yeah, inadvertent elbow maybe. Let's see. Yeah, inadvertent elbow. Kayla Combs. And unfortunately, Nyhill got that right to the face.
I don't know if I've seen a sequence where the player's face ran into the elbow and not vice versa, but I think that's what
true.
We saw there.
That is true. I'm certainly not meaning to laugh at the injury, but you're right. You never heard about that, you know. Oh, my face will run into your elbow. But yeah, I mean, both players just going after the ball. Obviously, Coombs didn't do that on purpose. She can't even really sense Nyhill coming up from the other side. Good to see it's not bleeding. But yeah, it looks like she's just trying to get some extra moisture out of her eye. Sid the Kid, hoping her sister gets better and gets back in this game. This is a very critical time. I mean, Nyhill has been everything. If she's having trouble seeing out of that right eye, the team's leading scorer, the team's only double-digit scorer, this is where Washington's going to have to step up. Talking about it all game. Yeah, it's irritated. You can see it's red. She's trying to do what she can to get back. But it's good to see that there's no blood, and she may not have to leave the floor and get extra attention from the trainers.
The heart and soul of the team on the bench. 3 to go in the third. Danger zone right now for the Drexel Dragons, the champs of the CAA. Where will the offense come from? Hi, Duke. Not that time. Hannah Nyhill set to check back in as soon as she possibly can on the next dead ball. Bates off the mark. May have traveled. No infraction. Basket will count. Hi, Duke. With 4.
Yeah, it did look like Haidu took a couple extra steps on that spin move. That's a great answer, an interior pass to Mallory Bates.
Bates, the backup to Stady, making her first career start. Under 2 to go in the third quarter. The Washington baseline, floater no good. The putback off the mark by Leonard. And Georgia with the board, that's Stady.
Well, the Drexel Bigs don't seem to have as much gas as they did in the first half. They're able to double and triple team down low, be active on the offensive glass. I don't know if their stamina has been able to last this long, because it looks like Georgia is just now getting into their real flow, and their bench, that's where this comes into an advantage. Bulldogs able to rotate 10 or 11 players. There's Drexel, you know, basically just been relying on Nyhill.
Dragons just 6 points in our third quarter. Still hanging around in San Antonio. Sadman all net. Mid-range is there, 37-33. Stady on the other end, count it, and a big shot from downtown for Jenna Stady.
Jenna Stady is 6'4". She can step out and make you pay. What a big shot by the senior.
Lady Bulldogs with their largest lead. 3-second differential between the clocks as our third quarter winds down. Oh. Washington against Morrison by this matchup. Six on the shot clock. He's got to hurry. Over to Sapman.
Oh, I thought that ball almost went in. Hanging on the rim.
Leonard puts it in. And how big was that, Brooke? The bucket at the buzzer and the lead trimmed to five to start our fourth quarter.
Yeah, it gives you life. It gives you that energy to say, all right, we are literally two possessions away heading into the fourth quarter. You want to see your season continue? You better hit shots like this.
Kelsey Riggs, Drea Carter, Monica McNutt with you for this studio update. Over on ESPN, North Carolina, Alabama going head-to-head, and Drea, Alabama has had the lead nearly the whole game.
They could use a little more of that from Jasmine Walker to help out Jordan Lewis. She's got the team on her back, 27 points.
Rutgers starting to pull away. They're up plus 10 on the boards, and Arella Garantes just hit a big three. She's got 17.
We are locked in on this game, too, though, Roy and Brooke.
Well, thank you so much, Arantes. Arantes getting it done for the State University of New Jersey, as she's done throughout her career. Joni Taylor offering a word of encouragement in a five-point game. And note this, just one win for teams seeded between 14 and 16 in the first round of the dance. And the last time it happened, way back in 98. So Drexel going to try to make some history here today. Brooke Weisbrod, Roy Philpott, 10 to play in San Antonio. And the shot rejected, the rebound by Stady.
Dragons still got some fight in them. I love it. I mean, here we are, fourth quarter, a five-point game. Drexel is a team that has just fought and been smart in getting this game to where it is. Now, they haven't found an answer for the outside shot of Jenna Stady. She's hit a couple really nice looks, and she's got that length at 6'4". There's really nobody that can compete and compare with that size from Drexel.
How impressive is it? Did not start. Barely played in the first half, and how productive she's been in the second. Now with 11 points for the game, she's been a big-time difference maker despite the slow start.
Yeah, it's huge because what we knew was that she was going to get limited minutes. So you don't know what that means, but Nihil getting crafty and creative off the bounce, finishing on the left side.
Oh, crafty and creative. I like it. Here we go for our fourth quarter, Brooke. Yes.
It's spicy. It's spicy time. Let's go.
I'm with you.
Nia was everywhere.
Shot clock under 10. The countdown is on. Nicholson goes to work. Nice skip pass. Coombs off the mark. The box out by Sapman. She controls the board and then throws it away.
Man, that hurts if you're Drexel. You play great defense. But again, here's Jenna Stady. Quick catch. Shot. Kate Connolly at 6'1". Can't match up. Nihil reading the defense, using her body. Look, if you're the height at 5'3 that Hannah Nihil is, you got to get creative. And she has shown so much hustle and grit out there. A lot of Nihil fans newly introduced in this game.
Her little sister Sydney told us this week she's the smallest one on the court, but she's typically the best one on the court. That has been the case at times today. Stady, she's been sensational as well. Give her 14 as Georgia extends the lead.
I love the adjustment that Georgia and Joni Taylor made. Bring Stady out, let her shoot. You know, if you're gonna double and triple team her inside and make it difficult, well, guess what? She's got range and she can make you pay in other ways. So against that zone, putting Stady up top there, Nihil can't compete, she can't even contest.
Brooke, she made six threes all year prior to today. She's perfect from downtown with two made shots from bonus land and a layup there.
She's got that smooth stroke. I mean, look now, perfect from the field. So, yeah, it took her a minute to get going. She didn't start. She has found her rhythm and flow in this game. That's why she's the leading scorer for this team and such a matchup nightmare.
Just like that, the lead balloons to 10, the largest for the Lady Bulldogs. Washington tries to answer and cannot. Now, the one thing you can say for Georgia fans watching, this game has been close. How many times have we seen where a high seed is tested early in the dance, and that's kind of the wake-up call that they need to make a deep run? And this Georgia team certainly constructed this year with the seniors, and the graduate students to be able to do exactly that. Lead is 12, 7 to play in San Antonio.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
In San Antonio, let's take a look at our Capital One rewarding performance. All 16 points for Jenna Stady coming in the second half. She has been perfect from the floor, Brooke.
When they needed them the most, she scored 10 of their last 12 points and has done it by stepping away from the block. She's got a beautiful looking jump shot. Oh, and yeah, by the way, she can hit the three. That's not a typical shot for her, but this is not a typical season. We're in the tournament. Jenna Stady, the leading scorer for this team, has shown up in a big way after not starting.
Bracket looks like this. Winner of this one gets the winner of Oregon, South Dakota. That game right here on ESPN2 late tonight, 10 Eastern. Top half featuring number 2 seed Louisville. Dana Evans will get Marist tonight on ESPN at 8. We'll have the call of Northwestern and UCF. We're looking forward to that one. It may take 48 or 50 points to win it. On ESPNU at 4, we encourage you to flip on over and check us out for that one. And check out Veronica Burton, leads the country in steals at 4 per game this year.
Not only that, you got UCF, who's leading the country in defensive field goal percentage. So both teams, a little bragging rights for being one of, if not the best defensive teams in the country. I hope there's a little more talking on the floor, ladies.
Nihil right-handed finish again. For Nihil. Offhand getting it done. Lady Bulldogs in transition and a foul called. Free throws coming as Borky picks up the personal.
I mean, so quick, tight ball handling, and then the underhand scoop with the right hand or offhand off the glass. That's through 3 Bulldog defenders here. Even a 4th to come over and play help side, but Bates is too late.
So Bates with 2 free throws. Don't forget, NCAA Men's Basketball Championship Sweet 16 begins Saturday on CBS and TBS. Or you can also stream the games on the March Madness Live app from anywhere. For more information on game times and networks, go to NCAA.com. Let's see if the Dragons breathe some fire and some more life back into this game. Brooke, the question is, do they have one more run to try to get back in it?
I believe they do. You know, but one thing we haven't, well, 2 things we haven't seen. Washington still at 5 points, and this will be the first time that Drexel steps to the free throw line this entire game. So what they're up against right now is the clock and the score. So what they can do are plays like this, being aggressive, trying to draw a foul and stop the clock. Pepper that in with a few Nihil threes, and Drexel back in this one. But the Bulldogs are so tough defensively. This is not a team you want to get down double digits and try to fight back into.
Joni Taylor prides herself, her program prides itself on that fact. Their toughness, their sense of relentlessness. Lady Bulldogs with just 4 team fouls in the game as Nihil looks on.
That's a sense of an experienced team, a disciplined team. It doesn't surprise me knowing that you've got a group of seniors with over 300 career starts. They know how to play smart, especially come tournament time.
And you talk about a roster that is constructed to make a run. That's certainly near the top of the wish list to have that senior experience. You mentioned it earlier. I asked you the question, at what point does Georgia start to feel a little nervous in this one? And you said, you know, I don't think that's going to happen just because all of these players have been with Joni Taylor's program now for these last 4 to 5 years. And that experience translates into a sense of calm, even when the circumstances surrounding them are vastly different.
Well, what happened when you asked Joni Taylor? Was she nervous?
She looked at me dead in the eye through Zoom and said, no.
There's your answer.
And I didn't ask another question.
You don't need to. There's no follow-up to that. Okay, I got it. Now, Coach Taylor, she does not get nervous. She prepares so that she does not get nervous.
That's probably my favorite moment of the Zoom pandemic era, in talking to coaches, football, basketball, baseball. And I just asked her, hey, are you nervous? No. And
no.
I just like, oh, okay, let me go hide back here in the back part of the room.
You
I'm
felt
sorry.
That, didn't you? That's right. Now the question is, Roy, are you nervous?
And the answer is yes.
I just love what she's built at Georgia. It's a program and a culture where players want to stay. I mean, we hear all the time, transfer portal, players leaving. Not at Georgia. They want to stay and play for Coach Taylor.
10-point lead halfway through the fourth. Anani Hill, the leading scorer for Drexel, 16 points. Dragons just 1 of 15 from three-point range. That certainly has been a story, as has Jenna Stady coming off the bench. Morrison, the runner. Nicholson. Lady Bulldogs get it back with a fresh 20.
Yeah, they could reset, run through some screens, get a look, you know, maybe rotate the ball from one side to the other. And that's going to be a foul on Nihil, raising the arm bar.
I want to say your middle name back at Coastal Carolina, you're the Big South Player of the Year, was arm bar. I can just see you, the arm bars everywhere. It's all over the place.
Well, we were encouraged to be physical, I'll give you that. Now, I was always trying to draw a charge. Typically, I was the one that got arm barred.
I don't believe that for 2.5 seconds.
But look at Nihil. I mean, still trying to stay step to step. Very active defense for the Dragons, but I'll tell you, the active player on Georgia for me, and one of my favorite players who's just emerged so much, especially this season, is Q Morrison. She's put up double figures the last 11 games, and watching her in the SEC tournament and championship, just you felt her passion and energy for the game. This is a player who's overcome so many injuries, so to finally be rewarded as a senior and the SEC co-defensive player of the year, she set the tone almost at a triple-double land here. We could see that happen tonight.
Couple more points, certainly possible. Don't forget ESPN and the ESPN app, home for all of your NCAA Women's Championship action. Final Four tips off April 2nd. The championship played on Sunday, 6 Eastern. That is April 4th over on ESPN. Yeah, if Q can put together a triple-double here, that would be incredibly impressive. And Coach Taylor talking with us about Q and her development this week. Brooke, you mentioned the injuries. But she said she's just built differently, and she came to us like that. It's different DNA with Q Morrison, her intensity, her passion for the game, and for UGA.
The coaches dream of a player like that, because if you need to, you know, tone down the energy, it's either easier to lower the volume than to ask for more.
Here's a steal, Nihil the mid-range. Zatman the putback, and she connects, the lead back to 10.
Speaking of outstanding performances, how about Aaliyah Boston? 20 points, 18 boards in their first-round matchup. We heard a lot about Paige Becker. She put in 24 in her UConn debut in the postseason. And Natasha Mack, whoo-wee, Oklahoma State's finest, 27 points, 15 boards, 4 assists, 4 blocks, and 2 steals. That is a line.
Stuff in the stat sheet, what you love to see this time of year. Nihil. Nicholson, the rebound, and Georgia in control here with possession again. Stady was fouled.
And you notice that Georgia doesn't have to pull back on the pace. If they've got transition points, they're going to go ahead and run. They're not going to be somebody they're not here in the closing minutes of this game. But you see they are passing a lot smarter. The second half, Georgia's found a way to cut down on the turnovers big time.
Jenna Stady trying to put together the Christian Laettner line from back in the early 90s, where he was perfect in that OT win against Kentucky to go to the Final Four that one year. Coming off the bench today. Well, that's the classic announcer jinx.
Yeah, good job.
I was just trying to think back on maybe the only perfect performances we've seen. That was the first one that popped in my head. He was 8 for 8.
Yeah. Stady's had a fantastic finish after a slow start. She didn't try to force anything. Found her way into this game. And you see just the way she's posting up and her reach. Finish here. There's really no contesting that for Drexel. They don't have that same length. And that's incredible. That is a state champ backstroke swimmer right there. Imagine getting in the pool next to Jenna Stady and thinking you have a shot. You don't.
I was going to say, no chance whatsoever.
No. I could literally be like, okay, so in the lane next to Michaela Phelps.
Another free throw coming. Now with 18 points, 7 of 8 from the floor. 2 for 2 from downtown, and now 3 for 4 at the stripe. 19 points all coming in the second half for Jenna Stady.
You wonder if this is going to be an adjustment now. Is Georgia going to bring Jenna Stady off the bench instead? You can't imagine that's going to be the case in the second round.
I was going to say, can I be the analyst for a second and respond
to
that? The answer is no.
No.
Bucket inside and a timeout called by the Dragons. Joni Taylor's team, the 13-point lead, under 3 to play. Q Morrison, 9 points, 11 boards, and a career-high 8 dimes. Nearly a triple-double for the senior.
The compliment to Jenna Stady has been Q Morrison. Hit a big shot at the end of the first. Hit a big shot at the end of the second quarter. Has been so active off the bounce, and that's where overcoming those injuries in a game like this means so much. She's scoring, she's rebounding, she's getting steals, extra possessions, and that energy to go along with it. You're going to see her always operate at a high level. And that's contagious, Roy. You love to play with energy players like Q Morrison. Maybe she's not going to have 20, but she's flirting with the triple-double right now, and that is incredible.
We get a triple-double in the tournament. That's SportsCenter top 10.
Yeah,
that's
it is.
Where we are, easily. Full court pressure now applied by the Dragons. Champs out of the CAA. Foul called. As Chapman hit the deck hard, she'll be slow to get up. Chloe Chapman grabbing that right ankle for a moment.
Well, the go-ahead pass was from Morrison, again, leading the break, breaking that pressure. She understands how to take over the game when no one's going to the ball, being that alpha. She's saying, give me the ball. I'll make something happen.
Well, you think about the Lady Bulldogs and their trek through the SEC tournament, defeating top 20 Kentucky, top 2 Texas A&M, the team that claimed the regular season championship. That was the first win over a top 5 team. Went all the way back to, 2013, I believe, for the Lady Bulldogs. You beat teams like that, that's going to give you a certain degree of confidence no matter who you face in the big dance. And now getting through this Drexel test, look out Oregon or South Dakota in the second round. I think that this team will be primed and ready to roll.
No doubt. Georgia is a program in the NCAA that has been consistently good. 34 times they've been to the NCAA. That's tied for the second most appearances with Stanford. Been to the Final Four twice. I think back to the Kelly and Coco Miller era. Everybody knew about Georgia then. And now under the leadership of Joni Taylor, you can imagine and feel that this program will have Final Four potential and capability. You know, this year they're a 3 seed. They've got a great shot as well, but there's a lot of good teams in this tournament. But no doubt in my mind, within the next 2 to 3 years, you're going to see a Georgia team reach the Final Four.
Well, our first round coverage continues here on ESPN2. Stony Brook and Arizona, 2 o'clock tip Eastern, Belmont and the Zags. That's at 4. And then coming up later, Troy and Texas A&M. We just talked about the Ags. Head coach Gary Blair, 6 o'clock tip. Followed by Bradley and Texas at 8. All those games right here on ESPN2. And Brooke, you and I had a chance to get to know the Stony Brook Seawolves in their championship run, and that's a team that's got a lot of fight in it.
Oh, you're talking about Annie Buckets now. Yeah, we know all about Annie Buckets. That would be AKA Annie Warrant from Stony Brook. A lot of firepower.
First trip to the NCAA tournament for the Seawolves. That'll be a fun matchup as soon as we're done here in San Antonio. Stady, rare miss. Morrison, another rebound. Off glass! Morrison now in double figures, a double-double to go along with her 8 assists.
All right, well, that's what I'm cheering for now. 2 assists for Q Morrison. Wonder, does she know it's out there?
You did the same thing I did. We were both checking out our stats monitor to see if she had another dime somewhere that we missed and that she would just be 1 assist away from the triple-double. Nihil from downtown. Lead trim to 13 with a 116 to go.
Well, this would be the timeout. You know, somebody whisper in Q's ear, hey, another couple of dimes, you got that triple-double. Now, I guarantee you she's not thinking about the stats. No good player would think about stats at a time like this, but if
she
somebody
knows,
else
though,
is,
right? Somebody's watching. You can say something.
If somebody told me, that's the first thing I'm doing is hunting for 2 assists.
Bracket looks like this. Georgia looks like we'll survive. And we'll await the winner of Oregon and South Dakota. Game coming up later tonight. And Eastern right here on ESPN2. Brooke and I have the call from Northwestern UCF, 4 o'clock on ESPNU, upper half of the bracket. That game today, and then Louisville and Marist. Dana Evans, ACC Player of the Year. It seems like the last 5 years she's been so sensational. You wonder if this is Louisville's chance, like we've talked about with Maryland, another 2-seed. Very dangerous, very explosive are the Cards.
They are, and you talk about the Cards. I mean, Dana Evans, you think offense, you think toughness. But Louisville has been that program to be known for their defense and their ability to change defenses within games, within possessions. They are very flexible in how to win and how to guard you. This team, they're deep, of course, led by Dana Evans. I think they've got a great shot. They're also in my pick to get to the Final Four.
Well, you've got everybody going to the Final Four. How does that work?
I do not either. Got 4 teams. They only allow 4. And I only filled out 1 bracket. Unlike some people, you know, that put like 10 or 12 together. That's crazy.
Now, Q Morrison not on the floor. Off the steal. And Satman couldn't finish. Under a minute to go in San Antonio.
No, Q.
Lady Bulldogs are going to win. And they will win this one going away. A game that was much closer through the end of our third quarter before UGA found its rhythm. Jenna Stady getting it done off the bench today. And Brooke, the only thing that matters this time of year is getting the dub. And the Lady Bulldogs going to do that as Nihil now has 22.
You got to give a lot of credit to Drexel. I mean, what a game. Now, Nihil was 10 of 22, is 10 of 22 from the floor already. No other player has reached double figures. She's got 22. She needed the help from her dynamic duo mate, Keshawna Washington. Now, Keith was 2 of 12 today, just had a tough afternoon.
Well, Georgia Lady Bulldogs, runners up in the SEC tournament. Now advancing to the second round of the Big Dance. And Coach Joni Taylor hoping her team can make a run. They feel like they're built for it this year. Nothing we saw today would dispute that notion. That'll do it, 67-53, the final. Gonna Stady off the bench. Q Morrison sensational as well. Brooke, final thoughts?
Well, I think Georgia found their flow in the second half thanks to Stady coming in and knocking down consistent shots. But yeah, the fight from Drexel, they made it a fun one.